Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Medieval Engineers on the Radio Man 03, and it is awesome to have you along. We're here at the mine. Oh my gosh, so many great comments in the last episode. So many fabulous comments. Thank you so very much. Hope everyone is doing fantastic today. Let's pull our stuff back up. I've got good news. I can do what I wanted to do right here, thanks to your tip and telling me exactly what it was that was going on here. Okay, let me finish this one up real fast here first. I wanted wood floor here. Last episode we were talking about it, and when I came up the stairs, remember I was getting snagged on the floor. It wasn't letting me up. You guys so intelligently informed me that it's because this had not been built up yet, the floor piece, and the stairs had not merged with that floor piece. So let's try that again. We're going to actually do it over here at this little piece right here. And we're going to put this in right here, and we're going to do number four. Now, see here, I can't get up the stairs. I get stuck. So let's do this. We're going to take care of a few things today that you guys brought to light for me in the comments last episode. Thank you so very much again. Absolutely, you are all very, very, very fantastic. All right, let's do that there. We're going to put this bad boy right here because we want it there. Oh, we need wooden sticks. Of course I do. The sun's coming up. It's a fine, fine day on Medieval Engineers. Hope you guys, again, are doing just fantastic. I am doing great. You can see I did not finish this floor yet. I pretty much got done with the last episode and ended the record and walked off and edited the video and got it posted as quick as I could because I do love getting your feedback and your information. So, here we go. Let's get this one knocked into place. These should probably go the long way when they get down here, but for consistency's sake, I'm going to leave it this way. And that word consistency, we're going to talk about that a little bit today. Okay, so here we are. We're at the stairs. Oh, it fused. It did. Okay, it fused already. Okay, goodness. Now, this last one, this up here, it would not do it. It would not fuse. I put this all the way in, this piece of flooring, and then the stairs, I could still get jammed up here. So what I did, from your tip, was to tear the staircase completely down. I had to tear it all the way down. I tried partially and then rebuilding it, and that didn't work. So I tore it all the way down, put it back in, and when I did that, they fuse together and they work out beautifully. But look at that, now we've got wood floor down there. Alright, something else I want to talk about today. Let's head outside here real quick. Sword in hand, please. Thank you very much. Well, by the way, today when I first got on, I wanted my hammer in my hand first. That's where I left off last time, and you can see right now, the sword is not in my hand. I can hit 1, 1, 1, nothing. 2, nothing, 3, my axe shows up, 4, my hammer now shows up, but number 1, it does not show up, so if I go to inventory, I don't know if you guys have this problem, if you take it out, and you put it back in, it should show up, there it is, now what about number 2, no, number 2 still is not showing up, so let's go, whoops, sorry, inventory, let's take our pickaxe out, and let's slide this pickaxe back in. I don't know, it's probably something they just have to work out, but there we go, now we've got all of our tools showing up where they're supposed to be. 2, 3, okay, beautiful. All right, let's go ahead and do a little something with this flag. Again, another wonderful tip from you guys reminding me that radio, sometimes these things have multiple ways of using them. So let's take this out of here, and let's get this up here. Yeah, there we go, and let's take this out of here too. There we go, beautiful. Mm-hmm. We're gonna get some things ironed out today and figured out today because you guys have got a lot of requests in terms of this build, and I could not be happier about that. I'm absolutely loving it. Let's go inside real quick. But it's going to require some changes out here at the mine. Let's go to our inventory. Let's pull the flag. Oh, the flag is over there. Let's pull the flag and bring it down here. The flag has a plus sign on it. I can change what kind of flag it is, and I just completely forgot about that. I mean, look at the choices. We got 3. We got this huge personal flag. We got this large personal banner, and we've got this medium personal banner, huh? Let's go put this back up again, but we're going to put it someplace where we can actually see it really neat and cool-like. Let's go E. Oh, mama, look at that. Oh, that is cool. That is cool. Okay, let's take that down. I know, but radio, you just put it up. I know. I want it up higher. Oh, I love that. On each side of the door there, look at that. So, again. Yes, again. I know, I could be kind of a pea brain sometimes, but you gotta remind me every now and again that, don't forget radio, you got multiple options in there. Those of you who don't know it, maybe new to the game, anything you see with a plus sign on it has multiple options, and that's something I have to keep reminding me over and over and over again. By the way, somebody else left a comment asking, how do I get those banners? You got to go right here to the banner workstation, create this first, access it, and then you can create your own banners there. When you're in there, if you're playing single player like I was and you don't have a faction, go ahead and hit H, and then that's going to pull up this little flag up here on the upper right-hand corner of that. We talked about it in the last episode, so we won't dwell much on that. Inventory. We are going to do something else. Bang, barbarians think they can just push us around and tell us what we can and can't have. Ah, it's not going to be in the middle. Right there. 20 stones, I believe, is what we need. Let's do that. Let's get 20 stones. 5, 10, 15, 20. There we go. Bingo. 20 stones. We're going to claim this area, too. This is our mine. It's ours. There we go. You know what? Should we move it? Maybe this is not a good spot for it. I don't know. Dang it. I kind of wish it was centered a little bit more, don't you? I really do. I don't want it to be in the way. I want to be able to walk through here. So maybe we do put it kind of back here in this corner right here. Is there another spot for it? Does it look good over here maybe? Oh, that might not be too bad. Let's control and scroll. Just love saying that. Control and scroll. Let's put it right there. Let's do it right here. Oh yeah, come on. Bring it on. We're going to feed this stuff some material, too, to get these taxes paid for. Oh, it's a contested area. We have to wait 10 minutes before we can add taxes to it. So we're kind of waiting right now. This will be our second piece of land. I figure we're going to need about maybe four chunks, maybe five or six. Maybe we're going to take the whole dang planet. I don't know. I just don't know. What else was I going to do today? Okay, other suggestions. We had this issue right up here. Keen Software says it's because this is a pillar and this is a rounded wall, that's why we're having the issue with the rail up there. So it's not going to happen for us. Another suggestion was another staircase, and I would imagine the way that you were thinking of the staircase coming off would be we would go up this way, up on the staircase this direction here. I don't want this to be any taller. I don't want to add another floor to it. It is, after all, a mine. I think I've gone to quite an extent, and it's quite elaborate for a mine, so I don't think I want to go any higher with it. Another idea that was suggested was two chests standing up side by side right here, and we'd be able to access them and create that. So that's another idea, and that one remains in play. Now, the other thing that you guys would like to see is a roof on this. Now, I don't know that I want to put a roof on all of it. I feel like it might overdo, and I don't know how the structural integrity to do will be for a roof that's going to go way up here and way back down. I don't know if it'll hold up. Have I tried it? No, I have not. I think what would be most important for us to have a roof over would be this section down here where we have our storage area and our furnaces and our workstations. So maybe what we do is we work out a way to get a roof to come across right here where the stairs is, something right across here. The thing is, we are going to lose, I think we're going to lose this arch, and I didn't want to lose arches. Now, with that said, let me tell you about something else. I've got an idea. A lot of you, I would say the majority of you, want to see some sort of a system, a pulley system, rope system, cart system, in terms of us bringing the materials from here to where the kingdom is going to be. And I can't argue that, because it is necessary. It would be extremely important for us to be able to do something like that. Let's pull up our sword. Let's close the door for a second real quick. I've got something I need to drop off over here real fast. Oh, you know what? We need to build something. We need to build a little tiny chest. Yes, we do. We need a little tiny chest. Number 6. And we're going to put this little tiny chest. Let's move it someplace where it's not in the way, because we are going to be doing some work around here. Let's set it right over here by this guy right here. There we go. There we go. Oh, that's W. We're going to put it right back here, and we are going to put... I just ate that. Okay, so we're gonna take these guys and drop them right over into there, okay? that's our backup food over here, so that when we're working the mines, if for some reason I forget that I need food, because that happens, I'll have food. I want to kind of take a little stroll with you today. We're going to do some building as well, but I'd like to take a little stroll and start out right here. I am picturing us having our carts up on this platform and this platform. Okay, it's kind of up there. So let's do the best we can, and let's walk straight this way. Walk straight this way and see where it takes us and where we wind up, where our kingdom wall is going to be. If you remember, our kingdom, our keep, is going to be extensive. It's going to be a large building. So we're going to kind of ease around this tree and come back in this way. I just want a general idea, and we'll try to mark it. I think I've got some stick and stuff on me still, so I can do some of that. Okay, so we're going to have to cut back to the left a little bit here. Keen, of course, on Tuesday put out an update, a bug fix. They had made it so the trees were moving in the wind. I had not noticed that, but that was the case. They turned that off because it was becoming quite taxing on people's computers. So that may be something down the road that will come back. Personally, I don't need the trees to be swaying in the breeze. It's a beautiful thing, but I don't know that it's extremely necessary for me. Bush. Oh, it's a berry bush. Look out, berry bush. I'm coming through here. Oh, wow. This is going to put us right over here. Oh, my God. Is this going to be a good spot or what? This might work out really well for us, guys. If you remember, a couple episodes back, you see this big gouge in the earth right here in front of us. I talked about this being sort of we could put like a staircase and a double door right here, and this would be our access up into the keep from the mine. So, I mean, look at that. It actually bumps right into it, generally. Wow, that is, get your butt up there, little orange man. Go. Yeah, yeah, that would work out pretty darn good. Now, before we can do something like that, listen to me and of course, as always, you know, feedback is very, very, very important in my Let's Plays. This stone, this is a very temporary thing. This is just a piece, a small piece of what it is we're going to be build here, people. Keep that in mind, okay? Don't judge this for what it is right now. This is simply an area for us to keep our stuff away from these crazy barbarians, these bald guys that run around here wreaking havoc on the land, okay? What I want to do is I'm being very dramatic. I want to bring these stone blocks out this way, and we're going to encompass this area, maybe not right here, but we're going to come over this way, and we're going to come down, and we're going to encompass this hillside with the blocks, and we're going to get this all kind of blocked up and figured out. Then it's going to actually travel down this hill a bit, and we're going to actually meet up with this knoll right here. Remember this knoll right here? Oh, what the heck? Why did I die there? That wasn't a big jump. Was that a big jump? I ran here, and I jumped. That was weird. As he lay there dead. Clutching the air. That was weird. I don't know. I have no answer for that. Maybe I was going too fast. I was running and I jumped. Maybe I just ran and I jumped and hit that other area too hard or something. I don't know. Anyways, remember, this is going to come over here, and then we are going to do a wall across here, and our gates are going to be here, and the keep is back behind here. Okay? Keep that in mind. It's a substantial project to take on, but I think it would be a lot of fun and we could have a really good time doing it. We need to go down here. Look at that beautiful wheat field down here. I need to pick that stuff. Taking you guys with me, as always. Look at this dang barbarian out here. Beating on our stairs. Take a sword to the face, pal. Where's your bag? Where's your bag? There it is. Ooh, salad. Jerk. What were you beating on over here? My staircase? Whatever he was hitting, he didn't do a very good job of it, did he? Oh my gosh, look at that. Look at that. We're just raking in the wheat. Raking in the wheat! Gonna take this back and make some bread out of it. We need some additional food. Oh my gosh. It's a bumper crop, people. Look at all the wheat. Oh yeah. Look at all this gluten wheat we've got here. All this gluten. Oh man. Nothing like a good stockpile of gluten. Mm-hmm. I think it's funny everybody's trying to get gluten out of their diet now. Inventory gluten. Okay, we could probably pick a few more of these. There we go. Barbarians. You rotten brats. Yeah, so this is gonna continue on. We've got a lot of work to do out here. And I feel like I've got to go back and we've got to work on the mine some more and get some of that stuff taken care of, because there's just so much interest in the mine right now and getting that kind of ship shape. I thought it was, but there's obviously more stuff that people would like to see done. So, you know, aims to please. Something else that Keen did was they added the craft button to, we've got the craft button here. Let's do this and this, and let's do that. Let's craft up a few more of those. As many as we can. Okay, beautiful. Let's take those out of there, and we're going to go over here to our fire. Ah, yes, the campfire. The beautiful campfire. Let's take that, and we're going to take these pumpkins out, and we're just going to make a ton of bread. They added a craft here. I don't know if the craft was there already. I don't know. But a lot of folks were getting confused about whether or not just how it worked. Because some of these things you interact with have a craft button and some don't. And that's where the word consistency comes to my mind. Oh, beautiful. Look at that. Look at all that bread. So there's a craft button here now, and I think they added craft buttons to everything. I believe the furnace has a craft. Yeah, the craft. There's a craft button here now. There's always been a craft here, I believe. Is the mill have a craft? Yeah, it's got a craft button as well. Consistency. Like we were talking about a couple episodes back, he wanted to know, should we make this, like this wall slope has the plus sign because there is a right and left wall slope, where this one right now, you can interchange it. And switch the direction on it. Would we want to see this plus sign down here? And I guess that's where the thought of consistency comes to mind. Let's check our taxes. We've got 15 hours and 37 minutes. We're good. We're good. Excuse me. Oh, escape. There we go. Let's go down and get the rest of that wheat real fast. Let's say you go to a restaurant. It's your. You go to this restaurant for the first time, and you have the most delicious steak of your life you've ever had before. You go back to that restaurant the next time, and the steak is not quite the same. And then you go back a third time, and the steak is yet a different steak again, where it's just not. It doesn't taste the same. Anyone who owns a restaurant or has worked in a restaurant, they're going to tell you that, you know, consistency is a huge part. Because if people come to your restaurant and they enjoy your restaurant very much, they are enjoying the consistency of the food. They know that when they come there, they are going to have this wonderful meal. We're just going to throw these guys right in here. Look at the bunches of wheat. They know that they're going to have this meal they can count on. If they want that steak, they're going to come back and they know that steak is going to be the same. If they go to this restaurant a few times and the steak is never the same, they aren't going to come back because it lacks consistency. And in a restaurant, that's a huge, huge thing. With just about anything you do, consistency is important. Let's say if I do a newscast one way one day, and the next day it sounds awful and horrible, and the day after that it sounds good again, people aren't going to be so sure that they want to listen to me do that. If my videos do the same thing, you're not going to want to, watch those videos. You want consistency in them. So I would say that across the board, if you're going to do something once, you've got to do it all the way across the board and have that consistency so people know what to expect. And that would be my two cents for that right there. Consistency. Let's see. Oh, mama, this is so cool. Small house banner. Let's put a little small house banner out here. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, look at that. That's adorable. Little house banner. Okay, cool. We're good. We're good. We're heading back. Heading back to the mine. Let's see if we can work out some kind of a roof situation. So that's what I think. If you're going to do something one way, you got to do it the same way across the board. So when people, like for instance these things, if you open it up, you're going to know that that craft button is what you need to hit in order to craft something. So on and so forth. Consistency. It's a big word. It's a very big word. But I know how to use it. And dang it, I know what it means. Rudolph? Oh, he's not Rudolph no more. He's just plain old deer. The deer are back. That means the Christmas trees must be gone too. We got one Christmas tree this season. And a barbarian damaged it and vandalized it. He was really, really awful. Ooh, look at this. This is weird looking. I didn't dig here, did I? Oh, you know what? Is this forest spreading? Because this is where we dug that one time. And it was open land here. Is the forest changing? It looks like it is. Because there weren't trees there before. Stuff keeps popping up, which is fine. That's cool. I'm okay with that. I'm going to walk and grab sticks on the way back, if you don't mind. Because we need them. Boom, boom. I love being in the forest. It is really a well-done forest. This, I think I've mentioned it before, but we have... I live in the world's largest... Is it Ponderosa Pine Forest? And it looks just like this. Now, our scrub oak trees, like these little ones here, this is like a scrub oak, a maple or something like that. We have what they call scrub oak. And these scrub oak trees, if there's a tree that looks like it belongs in Halloween, it is a scrub oak tree. You can Google that and look at the images. They grow gnarly and twisted and crazy-like, but they're very cool. Very cool. And that forest out there reminds me of that. So, to change subjects extremely, extremely quickly, what we can do is we can put a cart here, we can have a cart here, we can have a cart here, we can have probably up to four carts up here full of stone that we will be able to transport back. Now, one person said, how about a cobblestone path? And somebody else said that would be a little too formal for medieval times. And I don't want to do a cobblestone path, but I would not be objective to some sort of a cobblestone or wooden trestle that runs from here back over to where the keep is, that the carts would roll along. Either we push them across it, or we hook them up to rope and we use a winch and pull them across. So, there is that, okay? Let's take a look at what we have going on for the roof. Let's take this off and this off, and let's put this down here, and let's just hang this up somewhere so it's out of the way and out of our inventory. We'll put you right there. If you're wondering why... Oh, it does have flames. I wonder if that got fixed. There for a while when you put a new torch up and you lit it, you couldn't see the flames flickering until you reloaded the game, but that one popped right on. To build a roof on here could be quite tricky. This is all of it. This is the tall round roof, tile roof tops. Okay. It might be a bit tricky. If I go up here and if I go to V and I scroll that way. Okay, if I control, can I get this to go over there and hook onto that? It wants to look at the floor. Let's go back to V. Can I get up on here a little bit higher? There we go. We could do that, and then we can actually come along here and do that and that. And we have this kind of a round curve here. A large round tile roof, okay. Yeah, that just doesn't want to do that. How do I get that to go? Let's try tacking one of these into place. Maybe it'll see it better or something. It takes timbers, right? Timber and sticks. Okay, that's fine. I don't know how much of this will be able to go up before it decides it's going to collapse, so we have to be careful about that. I do not have structural integrity turned on. I believe the only way I can turn on structural integrity is if I go into creative mode. It'd be nice if we could actually do that from this mode. I don't like going into creative mode. Anybody that watches me play, I'm pretty strict about staying in survival. Yeah, this is the right tile right here. Like that. Doesn't that kind of dangle off the back though then and look kind of weird? Maybe not. I think that is actually looking a little strange, isn't it, over there? I can't put this down here? Oh, come on now. How am I supposed to get up there then? I don't know how I'm gonna go about. Oh, what's this here? What did I saw? I saw something white. No. That's no good. Let's see here. Let's get the floor. Let's take this out and see if I'll be able to do something like this on here. I gotta be careful. If I fall off of this, I'm gonna be in some trouble here. Oh my god, this is not okay. Please come off. Thank you. I thought for a while there you could go to B. There it goes. Okay, that's good. And then how am I going to go about getting up there? Okay, hold on a second. Let's go G. Let's take this out of here for now, and let's grab our stairs, and let's see if we can put a staircase on here. Okay, I can do that. Awesome. Okay, so we can get up here then. No! Ooh, that was close. Sorry if I yelled into the microphone. I thought I was gonna die. Yeah, this is not correct over here. There we go. Let's take that off of there. And let's go to 7 again. And we need it to go right onto the end of this here. Control and scroll to it. No. Oh, you know what? You know what? I know exactly what's wrong here. I have this here. This can't be here right here. This needs to come out, and the curve needs to start earlier. That's what's wrong. Okay. You know, different angle, different viewpoint, right? So let's go back to 7. This should fit right in there perfectly now. You guys may have been screaming at me on that one. Come on now. There it goes. Wow. Jeez, is it just me or did that really consume a big chunk? Okay, so that means this is incorrect too, I would imagine, right? I'll tell you what, let me get this kind of ironed out and then I'll bring you back, because this is kind of a painstaking process for me. It's really a lot of trial and error. I've not done a whole lot of roofs. So give me a chance to get this kind of worked out and then I'll bring you back. Alright, we're back. I've got a roof up on the work area. It took a while. It took about 30-40 minutes for me to get that up there. A little tricky getting the pieces all to line up and stuff like that, but in the end, it's there. Now, the question here is, it's not structurally sound. I know that that does not have structural integrity. The thing we're going to lose here is, I think, is a lot of the openness that we have here with the way I had it. I was not going to put a roof on here to begin with, but it does kind of make sense to have a roof over the work area, especially, you know, the rain would be coming off this part of the roof and hitting right down here, which would be a mess, and then pour down into the mine. We could roof the whole dang thing, but wow. And probably structurally, it would be more sound. Can I get to structural integrity easily this way? Let's save. Let's try it and take a look. Let's see. Just out of curiosity, we'll try this out and take a look and see. Load world. Is it edit settings? Creative. Okay. And then load. This should be able to, and I believe it's the letter N we push to do this. I don't like going into creative mode because I feel like I'm in survival mode, so that's where I should be. And my eye tells me that that is not structurally sound just by looking at it. But I'm tempted right now to put... Oh. Well, that doesn't look so bad. Let's go outside, though. We must be getting close to the fall and winter solstice because the sun was only out for about 30 minutes and then it went away. It was dark again, so it's getting to be winter time here in Medieval Engineers for me. Mm-hmm. Pretty cool. Pretty darn cool. We've had a barbarian. I found him just standing out here wondering what to do with his life. I killed him. I said, there you go. You don't have to worry about it anymore, pal. You're dead. I took care of you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, I'm thinking I might go all the way around with this roof. Structurally, it looks good. I mean, it's got a little orange and yellow in there, but other than that, it looks pretty darn good. I'm a little surprised. I thought for sure that it would be like in the red, just brutal red. But it's not. It looks like it's holding up pretty well. But to be quite honest with you guys, we could really do the whole thing and have a beautiful roof across the top of it. I didn't think it would work, a roof on here, but it looks to me like it might. What I was going to do, and I was going to do these stone columns up to here, and then this is a stone archway, but we were going to lose a lot of this openness, because then what I was going to do is do a wall across the top here and kind of block that off, and I don't want to do that. You know what I mean? I want it to be open like this. So maybe what we do is we go ahead and go with, if I take this out, do we still have our integrity that we had before? Oh, that is quite blinding, but we do. Okay, so let's do this. Let's go back to exit main menu. Yeah, we can save the changes. It's okay. And then load world, edit settings, and we want to go back into survival mode. Okay. And load. There we go. So, yeah, I don't see why we don't put a roof over the whole top of the dang thing. Oh boy, we are up on top of the roof. Uh-huh. Now, in order to get this next level to go on, which is this piece right here, this is kind of a tile roof, the top end, I've got to put a piece of flooring down right here. Now, what I don't know, and you can see I've got, look at the scaffolding in here. Look at this crazy amount of scaffolding to get up here. It's just nuts. But I made it. I made it. I'm here. That's the main thing. So, what I'm curious is if I go 7 here, I gotta back off a little bit. 7. Okay, and then we need a 7 down on this end as well. But you know what? It's gonna be easier to do this here. This is the small tile roof sections for like a small home, like that there. And just to kind of finish off the top here. Oh boy, oh boy. We're almost there, you guys. It's taken me about 2 hours to get this accomplished. Between running out and getting resources and things like that, no big deal. It's been a lot of fun, and it's been quite a challenge to get it taken care of. We wanted the top end roof. Okay, and then this one will go right here. Like so. There we go, like that. Okay, let's start tacking these into place. We'll see if we've got enough to finish this up. I hope we do, because I've... God, I didn't even think about that. But you can see it's all snapping into place very nicely. I had some troubles last time I tried to do some roofing with it just kind of fusing together, but this one seems to be working out pretty darn good. We may have to take that... Oh, I got no more timbers? Wheat straws? What? Wheat straws for the tile roof? I need wheat to do this? I didn't think you needed wheat for this. Gosh, really? Okay. Let's see. Let's go to G. Tile roofs. Timber, 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 timber. All of it says timber. What does this one say here? Oh. Okay, some of them do and some of them don't. But some of them do call for the wheat. Okay. Well, all right then. We need wheat. So here's our scaffolding. Goes over to here. Then down. Comes over here. I put a different staircase in right here. Didn't take that one out because this would have collapsed. So, ooh, looks like the sun is coming up again. We can go right out here and get some wheat. We need some timber anyway, so let's do that. I'm going to take you guys with me on the rest of this because we're almost there. I'm very excited about having a roof on it. Take a look at that. It's going to look really good with that roof on there. And then we got to find some way. We've got to get the entrance worked up, too. We've got to get the entrance figured out as well. We definitely have to do that. We got wheat right here. Bump. Like that. And we'll grab some wheat straws from over here. We'll just use what nature has out and about for us. It should be enough to get us by, I think, hopefully. Get a few roof tiles put in. And let's check our inventory. Stick-wise, we're pretty good. Let's go ahead and let's take down one more tree. Our axe is just about shot. I'm hoping it'll last and won't break on me. Not that big a deal if it does, because we do have extras, but I wouldn't mind being able to smelt it down and not losing it. Oh, do I dare take one more? One more. Oh, can we finish this tree up with this? Inventory drop. Let's eat those. Yeah, confirm. Eat them. Eat that. Eat that right there. And then let's drop that. Let's turn these guys into timber. There we go. And this should be enough to finish that roof. Oh, wait, we had one more there. There we go. Beautiful. Okay, this should be enough, hopefully, to finish it. How much wheat do we have on us? Only 6 straws of wheat? No, we're going to need more than that, aren't we? That's not going to cut it. That will not cut the mustard, people. Dang it, I don't see any more. Just kind of growing out here on its own, nice and easy. There's a little more over here. I mean, we've got plenty back at the main keep area, but I'd rather not go back there. If we could just come out here and do this, that would be great. Do I have food on me? I do not. Okay, so I've got food back at... We dumped that food off over at the mine, so we're good there for food. Three. Get a little bit more over here. Let's grab this. Let's eat it. It annihilates your stamina for a little bit, but it's really not very bad. Actually, I noticed I ate 3-4 pumpkins in a row one time, and it had no effect on the stamina at all, it seemed like. The first one did, but the rest of it did not. And our sun is coming up, so that means we can do a screenshot when it's all done, and you guys will be able to see a much better screenshot. It's always been in the dark, it seems like, lately, but it's just kind of how things worked out. You know, we get started in the morning, and then it gets dark out, but right now we're on the winter cycle, it appears. Oh, yeah, look at that. She's looking sexy. I'm glad. I'm so glad you guys talked me into the roof. It looks really good with the roof on it. It really does. Yeah, that is just awesome looking. It definitely completes the structure, doesn't it? By putting a roof on there. I thought it would be kind of open air and a mine, but once we get this front entrance taken care of, it should be completely beautiful. And this allows me to keep this open airiness in here as well, so that's pretty nice. Okay, so now to get up here, we've got to come over here, and we got to come on down this way, and then up this way. Oh man, that barbarian is back again, wreaking havoc out here. Punk. Get out of here. I love the way they fall down. And what do we got in here? Oh, we'll just eat those. There we go. Beautiful. All right. Perfect. Get out of here, you guys. Come on. Why are you being like that? Uh-oh. What happened here? Oh, our tools are floating away from our body again. That's what's going on here. Yeah. Inventory, we need to pull the hammer away from us and then pull it back into our inventory, and that should straighten that out, hopefully. Okay, so now I think if we do this and we hit four again, there it goes. Boom. Now we're going to have the same problem with number three? No, it looks like it's got itself fixed now. It did that before. We've done that before where we hover the tools back into our inventory, ready for work again. Boy, this takes a while, huh? Mm-hmm. And then we jump up here and we crouch and we give a little jump as well, like that, and that's how we get up here. And then we come up here on the roof. Don't you dare jump all the way off. And we come running down here. And how many wheat straws does it take per? Two? We've 10. I think we've got enough to do this. I hope we do. Just a couple more to go here. And then we can take a look at our handiwork. This is what it takes to play, you know? These are the things you gotta do. And anybody new to the game is hopefully seeing a little bit of the scaffolding work, you know? How it works. There we go, and the stairs, like so, and the staircase right here, and whammo, we got it. Oh my god, would you look at the size of that roof? Ho ho ho, cow! What is this? This needs to come out of here. I'm gonna have to doctor this back up again. Shouldn't take too long though to fix that up. There, you go there. You spin around and shrink it down. Shrink it down again. Again. And then it goes that direction. There we go. We want that there. And we've already got that one there. That's perfect. We need the one underneath the stairs. And this looks like it's going to be an 8 or even a 9. No, it's definitely an 8. There we go there. And I believe I saw a little piece that we missed right in here. Yes, I did. And we're going to take that all the way down to a 2 and a 1. And we're going to put that right there. And that fixes that up right there. It was still in a workbench and I was close to the workbench. So we could do this right here and we could have those three chests right there. How does that look from down below? Tell me what you think. That'll work. I mean, that works just fine for me. It kind of blocks that area off and no one's going to walk over and fall off of that thing right there. But that is going to have to be it for me. Holy cow. Awesomeness. Awesomeness. It takes a little while to put it together. Medieval Engineers is like this really cool puzzle for me that, you know, sometimes the pieces don't go together the way you want them to. You have to work it out a little bit, but that is some of the fun part for me. But there we go. We've got a massive roof on here. I'm going to go up here so I can take a look at it a little bit better. Oh, yeah, that is just so dang cool. It is such a massive roof. A massive roof. Tab, V, Alt, and turn it around. And there you go, guys. There it is. The roof is on. We're a little bit further done with the mine. I think maybe next episode what we should do is get the entrance taken care of. I'm going to wrap my head around that. If you got any ideas, let me know as well. Drawbridge was thrown out there. A drawbridge. We could do a drawbridge on there. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep it relatively simple. It is just the mine after all, so we can go a little bit simpler on that. But anyways, hope you enjoyed today's episode. If you did, hit that like button for me. I'd appreciate it very much. Comment, subscribe, and share. I'm the Radio Man 03. Have an awesome, fantastic, and superb day. And I look forward to talking to you again next time.